Goodbye, my dear wife. You, my eternal companion. You are going too fast, and you are never going to come back. You are leaving a void that I could never fill. You are going, and I am very sad. And you are going, and I don't know what to do. You leave me totally afraid because you are not going to take care of me. You leave me crying, and you are not going to console me. Fortunately, you don't suffer anymore. Fortunately, you don't have any pain. Fortunately, you don't suffer as much as now I suffer. Adiós, esposa querida, tú mi eterna compañera, te vas demasiado pronto, te vas para no volver. Te vas dejando un vacío que nunca podré llenar. Te fuiste y estoy muy triste, te fuiste y no sé qué hacer. Me dejas con mucho miedo, pues ya no me cuidarás. Me dejas llorando mucho y no me consolarás. Por fortuna ya no sufres, por fortuna no hay dolor. Por fortuna ya no sufres tanto como sufro yo.
Judy, I come from so far away to tell you goodbye. And as I know that you speak very good Spanish always, I want to say some words in my own language. Vine desde muy lejos a decirte adiós, porque en el momento en que supe que falleciste inmediatamente, di la vuelta al carro, tomé mis cosas y estoy aquí. Porque siempre te he querido y te he admirado mucho, porque fuiste un excelente estudiante, una excelente persona en todos los aspectos, por lo cual mi hermano siempre te ha amado muchísimo. Quiero agradecerte de haber sido una gran cuñada para mí, porque hiciste de mi hermano un hombre feliz, porque compartiste con él tu vida en lo bueno y en lo malo, y porque sé que un amor como el de ustedes va mucho más allá de la vida y de la muerte. Por eso estoy aquí y te recordaré siempre como una parte de mi hermano, y a él siempre para mí será una parte tuya. Descansa en paz. Que Dios te bendiga y que después de cruzar el puente te encuentres a mis hermanos, a mis padres, a tu abuelita, a tu tía Marsh, a toda la gente que tanto te quiso, para que no sientas miedo y lo cruces y sepas que aquí siempre te vamos a recordar con mucho amor. Nunca te sientas sola, porque vas a vivir por siempre nosotros y especialmente en mi hermano por ese gran amor. It's a no ending love, what he feels about you. So you're never gonna be alone anymore. I love you and bye.
I met Judy 39 years ago. Yeah, I met her the third day I was at Stanford, and we essentially got together forever. We traveled a lot. Judy had a lot of friends, mostly in the geophysical community and in the Spanish literature community. And most of them are not here. Some are, but they told us that they are with us in spirit, if not in presence. I hope that all of you remember Judy when she was so happy and full of life. She suffered a lot in the last few days, probably a month. That at the very end, she was so happy that she didn't have any pain, and that's what I will remember. That she now has no pain.
Judy was a happy person. She made people smile. I met Judy at Stanford when I first came as a graduate student. In fact, that's where I met Luis and Judy and my own wife, Barbara. We all converged at this happy place. And so we go back a long way, and mostly what I remember whenever I saw Judy was good times. Always a smile, usually something good to eat and something good to drink, and lots of laughter. So thank you, Judy, for that. That was an important part of my life, and it still is.
If she could sit up right now, she was always so nice and didn't want to be a bother, that she would tell you today she's sorry for spoiling your day. And that she always had time to sit up and listen to me for many, many years, so.
I want to tell all of you that Judy was a very, very good sister-in-law, because she made so happy my brother. They share a long life together, traveled a lot, and they were very close one of each other. So I loved her very much, and I really like to tell you that it's gonna be very hard for all my family, this, because we all know that he really is going to love her until the end of times.
There's a saying in Mexico that goes, when you die, these people are waiting for you at the other side of the bridge. So we will one day see each other again, face to face. That God made us out of love, to love and to be loved. And he wants us to be happy and joyful. And that's what we look for, to heaven, our journey to heaven, okay? So we are here just for a short time on earth, but we look forward to being in heaven together as one holy family.
I'm a very lucky nephew. She is a second mother to me. I'll read this poem to Luis because I think it expresses a message that Judy wants you and all of us to know. The author is named Henry Scott Holland, and it's called All Is Well. All is well. Death is nothing at all. I have only slipped into the next room. I am, I, and you are you. Whatever we were to each other, that we still are. Call me by my old familiar name. Speak to me in the easy way which you always used. Put no difference in your tone. Wear no forced air of solemnity or sorrow. Laugh as we always laughed at the little jokes we enjoyed together. Play, smile, think of me, pray for me. Let my name be ever the household word that it always was. Let it be spoken without effect, without the trace of shadow on it. Life means all that it ever meant. It is the same as it ever was. There is unbroken continuity. Why should I be out of mind because I am out of sight? I am waiting for you, for an interval, somewhere very near, just around the corner. All is well.